because it's time for Grandma Calls. Wow, yes, we completely forgot about Grandma Calls. This is what we're going to do. We're just going to do one today, and then on Friday we'll do the rest, okay? Is that good?
We only got one submission.
Oh, we only got
anyway,
one. Wow, perfect. Wow, only one of you had the guts to give up your grandmother? It's time for Grandma Calls. This is Halloween, and what we're going to do is we're going to call. A listener has submitted. Now, let's pray. Thank you for posting that again. A listener has submitted his grandma's information. And, wow, the audience is saying, we don't have any grandmothers left. They're dying.
Mine are all dead, too.
Yeah, it's true. Believe me, I'd be using my grandma if she was alive still. I only have one grandma that's alive right now, and she's not. It's not comedy grandma. You wouldn't like it. So this is what we're going to do. Here's the idea here. A listener gives us his grandma's phone number. We call the grandma. We try to get her terrified. So this is what we've got. And he says this. He says, my grandma's name is Marilyn. She lives in a trailer park, and she's always scared it's going to close. Also, her husband has passed away, and my father, her son, lives in Massachusetts for more reliable details. Okay, I think I got that. Let's see, Marilyn. Hey, Marilyn, how are you, Marilyn? And your husband, I knew your husband before he passed. What is the husband's name? Can we get that? That would be a good one for me to have. Can you message that guy real quick and get the grandfather's name? And in the meantime, we're going to call him up. This is called a grandma call. And this is, yes, if you're not into this, this is 100% an innocent grandma being pranked. Okay? And this is our Halloween-themed grandma call, okay? And we might do three different calls to the same grandma because I've got three ideas here. Okay? Here we go.
Jerry.
Jerry. Great. Jerry. Hi, could I speak to Marilyn, please?
This is Marilyn.
Hi, Marilyn. I'm an old friend of Jerry's, actually. I work for the city, and I knew Jerry before he passed, so just wanted to say hello, and I've also got some news here today that you might not like.
Okay.
So, I work for the city, like I said. And we're actually going to be putting a brand new road through the city here. And unfortunately, it runs right through where your house stands. Do you know what I'm getting at here?
No.
So we're going to have to actually tear down your house in order to get this road built. Okay? And you've got about 24 days to get out of there, or we're going to have to place you in a mental facility.
Gotta be kidding. Do you really believe that I would believe such a spiel as that?
What do you mean a spiel? We're building a new road. We've got to make room for the road, and we need to, it's going right
and
through.
What road? What's the name of the road that I live on?
Well, you know, we're going to get into that later when I take out my maps and stuff like that. So the new name.
You must think people are pretty stupid to take and listen to somebody call up and say they...
Marilyn, you know, like I said, I was a friend of Jerry's.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Wait a second,
your
Marilyn.
Your mother would be very proud of Marilyn. Somebody
Marilyn, hear me out.
Elderly people up.
Marilyn.
And telling them they have to be out of their house.
Yes, 24 days. Marilyn, this is not a joke. I'm afraid this is not a joke. I know it's terrible, but Marilyn, why would I make this up?
Because you're stupid.
Well, Marilyn, please, I'm begging. We're here to offer you today $200,000 for your property, okay? Now, if you don't take the $200,000, you're going to get nothing and they're going to throw you out. I knew Jerry, so I'm doing a favor. I pulled a lot of strings.
To use my dead husband's name. You ought to be ashamed of yourself. I hope you sleep well at night.
Okay, Marilyn, we got to tell you, this was a big prank for the radio station. You're on the radio, Marilyn. You did it. Marilyn, you've won. You've stood up for yourself. That's what we were looking for, and you've won today. You've won the big prize.
Right.
And the prize is actually that we are going to be taking you from your home and putting you in a mental institution.
I think I would have to say for you to move over, because there is no way. You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Well, Marilyn, thank you for playing along, and we'll see. Will your house be removed in 24 days? Will it not?
You know the funny part of this whole thing? Do you want to hear what's really funny about this?
Yeah.
I live in a mobile home.
So you could just move the home right out of the way.
You are such a jerk. I hope you sleep well.
Yeah.
Your mother must be very proud of you, calling up elderly people, telling them things like that. Anybody with a little bit of dementia has a little bit of a problem, and you must scare the heck out of them.
Yeah.
You ought to sleep well at night.
Okay, Marilyn, thank you so much, all right?
Yeah, you are... I just can't believe anybody would do that.
I know.
That is an awful thing.
It's just wild. Okay. Goodbye, Marilyn. Thank you so much for your time. And with that, wow, what a show. What an incredible grandma. And hey, this is what I was talking about. These grandmas are not the grandmas that we grew up with. These grandmas are hip, they're equipped, and they're not taking no shit. They're not going to be used by anyone. Shout outs to...